Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Fairo. Today we'll be talking about bleeding control. First aid in bleeding control is very important as bleeding may occur anywhere, anytime. Bleeding or hemorrhage is characterized by the type of blood vessel that is damaged. It could be from an artery, vein or capillary. You can differentiate it through its color, nature and also able to control or not. From artery, it's bright red, spurting and difficult to control. If it's from vein, it's dark red, flowing and moderate to control. If it's from capillary, it's red, oozing and easy to control. Bleeding can be classified into open or closed bleeding. In an open, also known as external bleeding, the bleeding can be visualized clearly. In a closed or internal bleeding, it's difficult to visualize the bleeding and usually it occurs inside body cavities. There's no obvious sign in the early phase of internal bleeding. If the bleeding is severe, it may cause shock, which is a life-threatening condition when the circulatory system fails and vital organs are deprived of oxygen. How to stop external bleed? It's easy by applying dressing on top of wound and perform direct pressure. If the bandage is soaked with blood, do not remove it. Apply new bandage on top of it and continue giving direct pressure. The duration of direct pressure that needs to be applied depends on the source of the bleeding. If it's from vein or artery, it may take longer. There's no evidence to support the use of pressure points, tourniquet or elevation of an injury to control bleeding. Once the bleeding is controlled, evidenced by the later gauze are less soaked, apply bandaging throughout the injured area. This can be performed in a circular motion, firm, but otherwise not to compromise the circulation. If there's a foreign body embedded in the wound, do not remove it. Apply padding on either side of the object to make it stable. Hold the padding firmly in place with a roller bandage or folded triangular bandage and send patient to the hospital as soon as possible. If the bleeding is from scalp, the principle is still the same. Apply gauze and also give direct pressure. However, in the case of scalp bleeding, it may be profuse and may require longer duration of direct pressure. In an internal bleeding, there's bleeding inside body cavities following an injury such as a fracture or blow from a blunt object, and blood can be built up inside brain, chest, as well as abdomen. There will be swelling, bruises of the affected area. How to recognize the internal bleed? Patient can come with the signs and symptoms such as pale, cold, clammy skin, blue-gray skin, also known as cyanosis. They can have rapid, weak pulse, patient feeling thirsty. There's a rapid, shallow breathing. Patient can come confused, restless, and irritable, up to a point they may become collapsed or even unconscious. There may be bleeding from body openings, and patient may complain of a severe pain. Patients with internal bleeding need to be sent to the hospital as soon as possible. Thank you very much.